Ernest Becker's The Denial of Death is a profound exploration of the human condition, delving into the intricate relationship between mortality, culture, and the psychological mechanisms individuals employ to cope with the looming specter of death. Published in 1973, Becker's work has left an indelible mark on existential psychology and has been lauded for its intellectual depth and insightful analysis. As we navigate the pages of this seminal text, we find ourselves immersed in a thought-provoking discourse that challenges our understanding of self, society, and the human pursuit of meaning.
Before we dive in, if you find this content valuable, please hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and leave a comment below. It truly helps us grow. Now, let's get started.
The human predicament. Becker contends that the fundamental human dilemma is the awareness of mortality, and how this awareness shapes our thoughts, actions, and societies. He states, "Man is literally split in two. He has an awareness of his own splendid uniqueness in that he sticks out of nature with a towering majesty, and yet he goes back into the ground a few feet in order to blindly and dumbly rot and disappear forever." This dichotomy forms the crux of his analysis, inviting readers to grapple with the paradox of being both divine and mortal. Within this existential tension lies the essence of Becker's analysis, urging readers to confront the profound implications of our dual nature. The cognitive dissonance between our awareness of splendid uniqueness and the undeniable fate of mortal dissolution shapes not only individual psyches but also molds the fabric of societies. It prompts introspection about the motives driving human actions, the structures of belief systems, and the formation of cultural norms. Becker's exploration challenges individuals to navigate the complexities of existence, fostering a deeper understanding of the human condition. By embracing this dichotomy, readers are compelled to engage in a continuous dialogue with their mortality, transcending the boundaries of individual contemplation to contribute to a collective exploration of what it means to be both divine and mortal in the intricate tapestry of human experience. Escape mechanisms. In the intricate dance with the anxiety triggered by the awareness of mortality, Becker postulates that both individuals and cultures employ intricate defense mechanisms to shield themselves from the looming specter of existential dread. Among these coping strategies, the pursuit of symbolic immortality stands out prominently, manifesting through the embrace of cultural worldviews, adherence to religious beliefs, and the relentless pursuit of a lasting legacy. According to Becker, the irony of man's condition is that the deepest need is to be free of the anxiety of death and annihilation, but it is life itself which awakens it, and so we must shrink from being fully alive. This paradoxical interplay compels individuals to transcend the confines of their finite existence, seeking enduring meaning that extends beyond the temporal boundaries of life. In essence, the quest for symbolic immortality becomes a poignant response to the inherent tension between the desire to escape the anxiety of mortality and the unavoidable awakening of this anxiety through the very act of living. This profound paradox not only shapes individual behaviors but also influences the broader tapestry of cultural and societal constructs as humanity grapples with the eternal quest for significance and transcendence in the face of mortality. The cultural hero system. In elucidating the dynamics of societal coping mechanisms, Becker introduces the profound notion of the cultural hero system, a complex structure that endows individuals with a framework for significance and heroism within the broader cultural context. By adhering to cultural norms and embodying societal ideals, individuals find a sense of belonging and purpose that allows them to transcend the confines of their individual mortality. Becker asserts, "Man is a symbolic animal. His culture is a symbolic action system. It is his hero system that serves this purpose. It satisfies the massive human narcissism. This hero system, functioning as a symbolic construct, acts as a potent shield against the existential terror of death, providing individuals with a psychological sanctuary wherein the illusion of control and a semblance of immortality can be sustained. The cultural hero system operates as a collective narrative that not only bestows individuals with a sense of identity and purpose but also interweaves them into the broader fabric of societal meaning. In this intricate dance between the symbolic and the real, the hero system becomes a coping mechanism, offering a semblance of order and significance in the face of the inherent chaos of mortality. The price of immortality. While these defense mechanisms provide temporary respite, Becker argues that they come at a significant cost. The quest for symbolic immortality often leads to destructive behaviors, including the suppression of individual authenticity, the perpetuation of violence, and the marginalization of those who deviate from societal norms. He observes, to live fully, one must be free, but to be free one must give up security. Therefore, the fully alive person is one who accepts and even seeks insecurity. Becker implores readers to confront the paradox that true freedom and authenticity require embracing the inherent insecurity of existence. Psychological implications. The denial of death delves into the psychological intricacies of the human psyche, examining the ways in which individuals grapple with their mortality on a subconscious level. Becker contends that the fear of death is a powerful motivator underlying various psychological phenomena, from the development of personality structures to the dynamics of interpersonal relationships. He states, the fact that the self is fragile and insecure is the major anxiety and the major source of hostility in social life. Becker's insights offer a compelling lens through which to understand the complexities of human behavior and the underlying existential anxieties that shape our interactions, critique and controversy. Despite the acclaim surrounding the denial of death, critiques persist, challenging Ernest Becker's conceptual framework. Detractors contend that Becker's central thesis, positing mortality as the primary impetus for human actions, oversimplifies the intricate web of factors influencing behavior. Some argue that other psychological, social, or cultural elements deserve equal consideration. Furthermore, Becker's reliance on psychoanalytic tenets, notably rooted in Freudian theory, has stirred scholarly debates. Critics question the universality of these psychological principles and advocate for a more nuanced approach that accommodates diverse perspectives. However, it is essential to acknowledge that scholarly discourse often thrives on controversy, and the criticisms directed at Becker's work contribute to a richer understanding of existential and psychological inquiries. The enduring influence of the denial of death lies not only in its ability to generate critical conversations within academic circles but also in its impact on broader societal discussions. Becker's exploration of mortality transcends disciplinary boundaries, resonating with individuals grappling with the complexities of existence. In this way, the controversies surrounding his work serve to propel intellectual engagement and stimulate ongoing reflections on the intricate interplay of human motivations.